question. Thank you, Ailin. Very good video. Curious to know your thoughts in the Gerson therapy in healing migraines and autoimmune issues. Thank you so much. Okay. So when it comes to the Gerson therapy, it's not as detoxifying as regenerative detoxification. You know, with regenerative detoxification, we're focusing on the healing astringent hydrating fruits to move the lymphatic system, to heal things like cancers or to heal things like autoimmune diseases. When it comes to that, it's not so much that the body is attacking itself. I know that's what doctors like people to believe, but it's really just all about fear mongering. You know, they want to take the power away from the person by saying, well, you know, your immune system, your body's just attacking itself, so there's nothing we can do, it's incurable. And that's not true. The main immune system of the body is the lymphatic system. So for any of the people that are new subscribers, you know, welcome. I want to touch a little bit on this lymphatic system. So the lymph system is the body's main sewer system. It runs from the top of the head all the way down to the feet. It runs all throughout the body, just like the circulatory system does. And its main job is to actually transport waste out of the body through the kidneys. So, these wastes can be anything from toxins, obstructions, mucus, acid, acidosis, chemical residue, heavy metals, pesticides, anything like that. The lymphatic system takes care of it, as well as viruses, pathogens, bacteria. All that is taken care of by the lymphatic system to be eliminated out of the body. Now, since they're connected to the kidneys, the number one thing to focus on when you are trying to heal any disease in the body is kidney filtration. And if you guys haven't heard of kidney filtration before, I do have an article on my website, and I'll put my website down in the description below so you guys can check it out. It's titled Kidney Filtration, but you'll see when someone truly starts to go on a detox protocol, they will start to see these acids and waste coming out of their body through their urine. So it'll look cloudy, it'll look flaky. You'll see like sediment either like settling down underneath the jar, and that's what you want to see, because if you see clear urine, then that's not good. You're not digging deep enough. Acids and toxins are just recirculating in the body. So that being said, fruits pump the lymphatic system the most because the lymph system is kind of sluggish. It's kind of like slow moving. It's not like the circulatory system that pumps very fast. The lymph system needs some help, and what helps it is astringent foods. So the most powerful being grapes, citrus, limes, you know, foods like that are going to be the most powerful at pulling it, because the lymph system is a fatty based system. You know, it's very slow moving. So if, you know, the best analogy that I can give you guys to describe to you how the lymph system is cleansed through the fruits and the herbs is, you know how, like, if you're washing dishes, if there's like oily residue or grease on it, you need the power of soap. And oftentimes the soaps, they have essential oils like lemon essential oil, orange essential oil, things like that. If you use natural soaps, then that helps, like, pretty much scrape off that residue and pull it off of the dishes. In the same way, that's how your lymph system is in your body. So using the limes, lemons, citrus foods, grapes, things like apples or melons, anything like that, all fruits like that, that are high in hydration and astringency, that's what you want to focus on when it comes to healing your body of anything, of headaches, of autoimmune disease, of anything like that. With the Gerson therapy method, their focus is more on greens. Now, greens in the beginning of a detox program can be, you know, somewhat detoxifying, somewhat healing, because people are coming from usually a standard American diet, high in proteins, high in fats, high in processed foods. So when they remove all those things, remove the animal products and all those foods, right? Then they begin to focus on raw foods, which includes fruits and vegetables and greens. The problem becomes when they stay for too long on those vegetables and greens, thinking that it's healing their body and cleansing them, when in actuality it's not enough. You have to dig deep in order to heal chronic health issues and degenerative health issues like autoimmune diseases or even things like migraines. Migraines are really, really, really horrible to experience. I know because I've had many clients that have had migraines. Like I had one client that he said that he has experienced migraines for like since he was 15, and the guy's like, you know, in his late 20s now. So he's experienced it for 10 years, every single day a migraine, you know? And he's someone that's been, you know, pretty healthy, eating a raw diet, and it's still not strong enough because he's still eating greens, you know? So you have to kind of let go of the mentality that the Gerson therapy is all about, you know? They're all about focusing more on juices, specifically green juices like carrots, you know, starchy vegetables like that don't have power to move the lymphatic system. Things like headaches are caused by, you know, head congestion up here, definitely acidosis, burning up the tissues, putting pressure on the head, and also the colon. If the colon is backed up, then the head will also be backed up because the head is the on top of this trunk. So in order for this to drain out, to relieve the headache, you have to clean the colon and then it'll go down. Greens do not heal the colon. Like we were talking about before, this lymph system runs all through us. The reason why the colon gets backed up, the reason why tissue begins to break down, the reason why we aren't able to eliminate acids and toxicity is because of this lymph system being backed up. So fruits are definitely what you need to focus on. Now, also when it comes to the Gerson therapy method, they focus a lot on coffee enemas. Now, I don't think that that's a good route to go to, because coffee is a stimulant. It's very aggravating to the colon. And what you want is you want something that's going to be more like not too aggressive, but also not like not doing anything at all, you know? But I find it to be more of a laxative, a purgative, and you don't ever want to spasm the body to detox. You don't want to force it to detox, right? But what you want is to take like a more gentle approach while also addressing the root cause of the problem. So anyone that has colon issues, if they're having trouble going to the bathroom, if they're having constipation, if they're having toxicity in their colon, to heal their issue, they have to focus on the correct diet to actually clean the colon and also the correct herbs. I would recommend an herbal route instead of coffee enemas. Or if you still want to do enemas, I would recommend doing things like an herbal tea and using that as an enema. So like the heal all tea is really good for that. That's what I recommend to my clients. Things like the stomach and bowel formula, that will help move waste out of the body, open up that channel of elimination so you can start healing, cleansing the body with the migraines and the autoimmune disease. And also you can even, like, if you're still like up on the green juices, if you want to do that, I recommend even doing an enema with green juices if you want to go that route, because coffee enemas, they don't address the root problem. Coffee is not astringent, it's actually acid forming. So over time, if you overuse things like coffee enemas, you'll actually destroy your colon, you'll enervate it, and then it's actually addicting. So like I've seen this before, people have told me in their calls that they've overused coffee enemas to the point to where they couldn't have bowel movements without the enemas. You know, we don't want that. We want to put it on a more restorative formula, like the stomach and bowel number, whatever, like however many bowel movements you have in a day, you get either number one, number two, number three, and so on. So yeah, that's what I recommend to my clients and to anyone that wants to follow the true path of detoxification. Definitely no to enemas, you know, cut out the greens as soon as you possibly can, focus on the fruits, focus on herbal formulas that will help regenerate your weaknesses, and then you'll be golden, you know, with autoimmune and healing of the migraines, then, you know, you'll be golden. So yeah, that was a good question. Thank you very much. And I might touch a little bit up on that in the next video when I'm discussing things like tumors and cancers, because I know a lot of people tend to go through the Gerson therapy route when it comes to that, but in actuality, it's not strong enough. Same thing when it comes to like the medical medium program. These different programs, they're just not strong enough. They're good for beginners, but usually when people come into those programs, they have chronic health issues that they've been suffering with for a long time. So they go into these programs, they only get just a tiny little bit better. You know, they don't completely heal their illnesses. It's not addressing the lymph system like we said before, and that's what you want. You want everything to be strong in your body. You know, you want to address all your weaknesses through looking at your eyes through iridology. That's what I help people do, is I look at their eyes, I look at their symptoms, I make the connections, what's going on, what's weak. You know, if you feel like you need enemas, what's the cause there? You know, is it a nervous system issue? Because people with a weak nervous system, they actually have like trouble with peristalsis, trouble pushing the stools out of the body and going to the bathroom. Or let's say you have a lot of bowel pockets, you know, a lot of hardened stools in your colon, stuck in the bowels, that are preventing you from moving the stools along, then you need to address that. Or let's say you have major acidosis in your colon, it's highly inflamed. Or let's say if you have sulfur drug deposits, that's locking the lymphatic system in there. You know, everyone's protocol will look different based on what I see and their symptoms and their eyes. So yeah, that's what I recommend. Get on a detox protocol, and you know, don't mess around with Gerson therapy, because it won't lead you anywhere good. Especially those poor cancer cases, they go down the Gerson therapy route and it's just not strong enough, and then a lot of them pass away. So you know, I really wish people would know more about true detoxification with the fruits and the herbs, but that's why I'm here, to spread this knowledge and information to you guys, so you guys can heal. Thank you so much for watching and for tuning in. Like I said before, leave your questions and comments down below this video. And if any of you want to work with me one-on-one, I'd be happy to help you out. You can go to www.spiritualtropicalhealing.com, and under the services tab, you can find everything that I offer. So yeah, can't wait to work with you guys. And I love you so much. Until next week, take care. Bye.